New this morning, have you ever wanted to tour Eastern Europe but just didn't have the time or the money? Well, you may soon be able to get there without ever leaving the Susquehanna Valley. All you have to do is drive to downtown Harrisburg and get ready to go for a trip you will not soon forget.
Ready?
Anthony Ortega is about to take a trip without ever leaving the room.
Locked.
Thank you. Let's explore Russia.
What looks like a giant hamster wheel is actually the latest in virtual reality technology.
Virtue Sphere is essentially a giant sphere within which you walk and explore whatever you want to, really.
Powered by computers and virtual reality goggles, the Virtue Sphere at Harrisburg University is one of just a few in the entire country.
It's something new, it's something cutting edge, and no one knows what's going to become of the technology or what it's going to grow into.
That's exactly what Professor Charles Palmer was looking for. He wants his students to shape where the technology goes from here.
So imagine sitting on the front lines of the Confederate Army during the Civil War, or imagine being part of Martin Luther King's address, or sort of walking the lines of the Civil Rights Movement.
You can walk up to a fountain and hear the water rushing into the pool below. Or if you walk from concrete to grass, you can start hearing the crunch under your feet.
Anthony tells me it's like learning to walk again, only different. So I step inside.
I'm finding out that this is a lot more difficult than it looks. But it makes exploring Russia a little more exciting.
There are really no words, you just have to experience it.
He's right. Now there's no telling where you'll be able to go next.
It's really up to our imagination now.
Well, the Virtue Sphere costs about $50,000. Harrisburg University got theirs at a reduced cost since they are partnering with the developers, and it is not yet open to the public. I have to tell you that it is so much fun. It is really hard. Like, he makes it look easy. When I got in there, I landed on my butt more times than I cared
to admit. Well, it does look like it would be hard to walk in. Now, how did it feel, though, when you had the goggles on? Did it really feel like you were walking through, although it's still computer animated?
I mean, it's going to be refined a little bit, but, you know, it's kind of neat because you do feel like you are walking down a street and you can choose which path you want to walk down. Very cool.
You did good. Brave girl. I'd probably fall on my butt, too. I don't know.